Pekarim really getting the top side of the map ahead. TBQ pretty much packed up his jungle, went, all right, Beast is now my jungle. Acorn, you can have my jungle, and then we'll just go kill Flandre together repetitively.
Yep.
And won the game off the back of that.
Yeah, and Flandre was completely ineffective almost the entire game. LGD, they're going to take away Sejuani, who I believe was almost untouched in the last series. Interesting one as Snake, we'll see what they ban away. If it's the Hecarim, which it is, LGD almost forced to ban Nunu here.
Yeah, I think that Nunu is a ban that you have to go for, although we've seen Beast is happy to take the Gragas, so we'll have to see how that one works out.
Urgot also there.
Maokai Gnar becomes a little bit more of a priority here.
We'll see what LGD decide to ban away. There are a lot of options now available to them. And of course, being the red side here with so many champions now available, as Rek'Sai is what's going to get banned away. Snake, you have to think the Nunu going to be the first pick, but that's going to mean LGD, they have the opportunity to either go for that Kalista or the Urgot. So many options here for LGD if they want them. Vladimir also there, but Snake thinking about the Kalista, and this is dangerous work. TBQ, he has to pick up the Nunu here, and this might be Imp's opportunity to pick up the Urgot.
Yeah, potentially, or they can just go Nunu and use that to shut down the Kalista late game and not let them get any kind of scaling going. They also have the ability to take away the Gragas. They do.
What?
So Nunu, Gragas.
And are we going to see the first Smite teleport top lane Nunu?
No.
So it's going to be support Nunu.
Or
support Gragas?
Top lane Gragas. I don't know. Kali Trolls does it sometimes.
Yeah, it used to be a thing.
No, it still was a thing this season.
Ah, right.
Well, I think he played it 4 times.
Yeah, Kali Trolls is a strange player, though.
Good player.
He is he's a fantastic player.
Lovely gentleman as well. As Beast picks up Gnar for his top lane to Flandre, there's also a Thresh in there as well.
Okay, yeah, I was too busy thinking about Kali Trolls, and you're right, he is a lovely man. But Imp looking at the Urgot here, no surprises coming through, but he's going to lower their damage a little bit towards the later stages of the game and does decide that it is going to be the Jinx looked at. We'll see whether Imp does decide this or whether he's just cycling through some champions. Of course, does like to make a few odd decisions here as he's taken his jacket off as well. Getting serious.
Yeah, he certainly is there, as you see. He's thinking very hard about the Urgot with the Maokai Hobbit. That will be a support Nunu coming through there. So
and
Jinx makes a lot more sense than Urgot.
It does. You're not going to... Yeah, I didn't actually realize that. Nazir's banned away as well. You're not going to get any help there in the mid lane, but Barker thinking about going back to the Vladimir here, of course, does have to blind pick it as LGD do have the last pick. And no... Wow. So no Trundle ban to come through. And Flandre, he's thinking about picking that one up.
But then where does Gnar go?
Gnar goes...
Not another jungle Gnar, please.
Oh, is this jungle Trundle? Trungle?
I hope not.
Oh, it's not...
This is a weird pick ban phase from both teams.
Where is... Because... Okay, Jungle Trundle is terrible. It just takes forever to get through. But he is going to lock it in, and we'll see exactly where it goes as we head into this one. Godby, thinking about picking up the Anivia, of course, has had some success on that champion. He's going to give them a whole lot of consistent chilling effects across this one. Of course, Gragas doesn't exactly have that, but man, these lineups are looking very interesting. There's two junglers on one side and no junglers and two top laners on the other.
Yeah, so we'll have to see how it works out. I like that. That's a good explanation of exactly what's being picked up here, because Nunu, he's going to be put in the support position, probably not going to be as effective as you would like unless they go into a fast push situation. And with a Gragas, Anivia and Maokai, they certainly do have a pretty good siege comp coming through here where they can just load everything up onto Imp and let him tear through these turrets. And it looks like it is going to be a jungle Trundle. I have seen the day. That is crazy.
I remember when Trundle first was released, of course, building that Wriggles lantern into some boots and a frozen mallet was pretty frightening. Of course, you never got away from that guy, but you did need to snowball ridiculously, and I didn't see it work very well very many times. But
the other thing is, it is a one tank lineup, so they will be able to, as wow, actually no, it's not. That is a support Gragas. I'm done. It's not a one-tank lineup. It's a two-tank lineup. There's a Nunu in the jungle.
Yeah, there is.
There's a Gragas in support. There's an Acorn on Maokai, as you saw, against the Gnar. And there is a jungle Trundle. This will be a lot of fun, if nothing else, Atlas.
Yeah, we're back to the regular season, ladies and gentlemen. This is the LGD that you know and love, and Snake have decided to take a bit of a leaf out of their book. And man, this is crazy. It is going to be the Jinx into the Callista, though, so no Urgots to be messing with things. And we are going to have a pause immediately as we get into the game. We'll see exactly what comes through and whether this game's just going to be remade because they realize that, oh, hang on, we've got two top laners, and hang on, we've got two junglers. We don't really know what's going on. But I have actually seen support Gragas work out quite well. Of course, the barrel is pretty useful there in that situation. And of course, you work like sort of a pseudo Janna that doesn't need to flash Monsoon. You just throw a barrel.
Yeah, it certainly has some disengage potential. It has some good percentage health damage in there. You've got lots of slows. You've got a knock-up in your kit. Theoretically, perfect support.
Yeah, practically. Sounds like something you'd play.
Practically, it doesn't work out too well. Trust me, I've been there. So we'll have to see exactly how it works out. The other thing that I will mention about PYL is he may as well be a second jungler. Yep. So it doesn't really surprise me too much. We see him play Nautilus in kind of a similar fashion. So if they get the lane swap here, expect him to just gank mid lane.
Yeah.
Like he was a jungler. So there is a potential for him to try and get God V ahead in this lane. Yeah, I don't hate the pick. I'm confused by it, but we'll have to see whether he can make it work.
Yeah, and how does Trundle go in the jungle here in 5.6?
Bad.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking as well.
The problem with the jungle at the moment is that if you don't have very much wave AoE wave clear, you're forced to go purple smite.
Yep.
So then you don't have the cool challenging smite late
game. The cool
game,
one, yeah.
The one that makes you take no damage and do lots of damage. So that's the one that he wants to pick up. So we'll have to see whether he can make, I guess, Trundle work with the lack of wave clear. Maybe he grabs a Hydra, does something crazy.
Yeah, it could potentially happen. Of course, Cinderhulk is going to help out. But ladies and gentlemen, let's get onto the Rift and see for ourselves. And here we are, ladies and gentlemen. Snake taking on LGD for game two here. And everything's a bit mental. We've got three junglers on one side. We've got three top laners on the other, and then some other people.
I like the fact that you put Maokai in the jungle pool there. That was pretty cool.
Oh, I did
cool.
that for you.
Thank
I did
you.
That for you. I put Vladimir in the top lane, too. That one was for Papa Smithy.
Speaking about junglers that aren't good, Maokai. Sorry, buddy.
We saw Loveling do it.
Yeah, we certainly did.
That
I'm
was
still
pretty
not
good.
Convinced.
Yeah, no, I don't... wait, did they... No. Sad times. Not going to be coming through. Barker, though, has learnt how to start as Vladimir has decided to go with that Doran shield this time
well,
around.
Well, there's a lot of harass that comes out of Anivia. Her auto attack is very slow, so you even weave it in underneath turrets extremely well. Anivia is one of the most satisfying auto attacks in the game.
Flandre has a Doran's blade.
Yep, that's pretty normal against melee laners.
Yeah, but he's probably going to go into a lane swap, isn't he?
Potentially. You don't know. Maybe you can find him.
Yeah, okay.
Maybe they're hoping for the 1v1.
That's true. And he often does take that longsword 3-pot as well. So, okay. Understandable. Fair enough. I just got a bit spooked by it for some odd reason. But we are going to have Imp actually starting off the lane swap here as well. Has been in this top brush for quite some time. There are vigorous pings going through as LGD looking to start
so
off here at the
So they must know because LGD just walked over a ward and they saw the invade. So they know now that Gnar is in a lane swap situation, which means it's going to be pure double jungling. No one's going to be able to grab up any camps, although it doesn't look like Akon's doing that for himself. Actually gave the three little race over to Godby. You do that just to get him some early gold, a little bit of early experience. Gives you a creep early on the next level as TBQ, he picks up level two off that blue and Godby. That smooth Anivia auto attack. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Well, it's actually a lot better with this skin, which is normally banned, but not here in China. So he's going to be going for that super sexy ultimate skin, as Barker also picking up one. So a lot of expensive skins used here in the mid lane. But on the bottom side of the map, you did see the fact that Crystal was able to freeze out that wave, and it is only going to help Beast here in the jungle to have a friend who has an AoE ability.
Yeah, so... The thing about Trundle is he actually stays pretty healthy in the jungle. He doesn't lose much health. He has an auto attack reset. There's things in his kit that you would think would make it worth. But when we changed the jungle, when Riot changed the jungle, they did it to the point where the little monsters did a lot of damage. So if you don't AoE kill them really quickly, you have to prioritize them. And they do surprising amount of work against you as Alan needs to turn that dragon away from someone because Beast has taken three auto attacks from dragon when he should have taken none.
Yeah, well, he took a whole heap of auto attack from the dragon and did a whole lot of damage, but it is going to go down here as Beast is going to be able to smite that one away if he wants to. May actually decide to hold on to it.
Oh, he gets a lot of health back from dragon as well.
Yeah, not
Trundle's
too bad.
Passive real good there.
Yeah, the King's Tribute, not too bad. Barker actually controlling this lane relatively well as he dodges away from the Flash Frost.
Lots of people do this to whenever you're actually early game. Unless you can really land a good stun there and get the Q through for some critical strike damage, of course.
Or the E.
Anivia's E, the only thing that really does crit out of spells.
Yeah.
So, unless you can land one of them and line someone up early game and then get some harass down, you do struggle to push out and do other things as Anivia. So, really relegated to farming until level 6. And then when that point hits, you just put your R down, you clear waves, and you're fine.
You have to do the old Froggen treatment where you make games last for as long as you like. No worries at all. Barker going to use these Tides of Blood just to keep clearing out this wave. He's going to stay a whole lot more healthy with the extra health regen available from that Doran shield. The double jungling is continuing here. The best friends, Beast and Flandre, still hanging out with one another. Little chipmunk there pretending to be a troll along with his friend.
Yeah, support and top laner, however, join bottom lane, try and shove that one out as Imp has got an extremely deep freeze going in the top lane. Nunu, Gragas, and wow, fight!
Yeah, they're looking for something here. The flash away from TBQ as his Blood Boil is going to help him get to safety. PYL and Acorn hanging around here. Crystal decides he wants to stay with the wave.
There is no way you tank that, Crystal. That is a lot of damage coming through.
But speaking of a lot of damage, Flandre is going to find a wallop onto Acorn and then just crush his way out of there.
But
no
they
worries.
Broke the freeze. That's the important thing coming through there, Atlas. They were able to get it back onto the turret. Slowly now it will push back into their favor. Unless they can do a really cool drag trick, which I don't actually think is possible. I didn't get to see the bottom wave, so I can't really tell you, but looks like it is fro. No, they did. They dragged the minions off.
Oh, very cute. Ella, successful dragging
it
of the minions.
It will slowly push back, but it won't be as quick as you would otherwise expect. If you can grab the next wave, stack them up as well, might even be able to refreeze it.
Interesting. Well, Barker, transfusing Godby just a little bit here. As he is able to keep these Tides of Blood stacked up. Actually, no. He's lost the stack. A little bit sad.
Extra two cannon caster creep. So the only choice is to push that wave as quickly as possible now for Crystal. That freeze is over. Imp in the top lane. Actually, still he's going... he's reversed his lane as well. It must have hit turret. So both top laners now going to pick up a heck of a lot of CS.
Not too bad. Beast is hanging around here as well. He wants to pick up some more creeps. TBQ 10 CS in the lead as far as these jungle camps are concerned. Hasn't been back yet. Just decides he wants to eat as many things as he possibly can. Is the boomerang going to come through from Flandre? Keep himself able to pick up some of this CS as PYL and Imp now. I get very confused when there's a Gragas in a lane. I think, oh, why isn't he jungling? But no, this is support Gragas. Very interesting team comps coming through here so far. I believe they have been doing what they were designed for. Would you say that's pretty similar here?
Yeah, they got the lane swap through there. In the end, it probably hasn't benefited either top laner. They've been just left to their own devices. AD carry is getting very far ahead in this game. In the lane swap, as you can expect, the mid lane is very unperturbed by everything. They're just 1v1ing at this point. Imp probably has a better pushing potential coming through than what Crystal, although you would say Crystal's kill potential at this part of the game with stacking up some of the Rens is going to be a little bit higher, but looks like overall Imp's going to be able to push through a little bit quicker, so you'll probably give the edge over to LGD.
And as it looks like Crystal might be able to refreeze this lane here on the bottom side. Acorn, as you can see, actually staying around, wants to be able to pick up as much farm as he can. Sentinel going to be sent out here by this Callista just to try and spot out what's going on. Frozen Domain here by Beast, thrown down just so he can run around a little bit quicker. But Imp at level 6, able to threaten quite heftily.
Yeah,
oh,
certainly.
No refreeze. Interesting.
No, it's completely balanced, so it doesn't really matter. They're just going to be able to force Maokai away from it through pure presence there. As we see, blue buff has respawned and they're starting to hand that one over. There's actually an invade coming through from Snake, and that's why the bottom lane only. Now Vladimir will join them. Barker coming across here. So, unfortunately, Godby, his team didn't swap back for him, and he's going to miss out on his... Oh, no, he's not.
The reset comes through. Ella is trying to death sentence it back, but, man, this blue Sentinel really wants to go home.
Yeah, you can only... The change was you can only do it 5 times. It used to be 10. Kill jungle TF and Ezreal.
Yep.
By the way, so you can no longer play those guys because they take a heck of a lot more damage in their first clear. But what that means, TBQ probably going to be able to hand over this first blue buff.
Yeah, of course, Crystal needed to go back to try and pick up that wave. So a little bit of sloppy play there by Snake means that they can't take that one away. But, of course, not going to change too much on this map. But LGD just passively have picked up 500 gold lead, and they're going to take the first turret.
Yeah, so in the end, because a refreeze came through in the bottom lane after Maokai pushed out to allow the blue secure to come through for their team, they're able to pick up the first turret in the top lane. 8 minutes 40, they'll be able to swap back now with a 13 CS on their AD carry as well. And Crystal, he needs to get a wriggle on and try and take this turret down.
Yeah, he's looking to try and do it now, but of course it's still very, very high health. Akon, with all of that extra wave clear that he's got, Ventral Maelstrom going to be used here at the same time. And the Maokai able to clear this one off, and it only takes a few hits.
Yeah, that's an extremely healthy turret, and now the fast push composition really in a good position. They've got the 1,000 gold early advantage. They've got Pickaxe BF Sword coming through for their Jinx. Not to mention the fact that they've got a Blood Boil. They're just able to rip through structures at this point in the game.
Yeah, this Outer Ring of Turrets is not going to be here for too long. LGD.
Oh, the Scar Award. Poor PYL, he missed it.
Oh, a little bit sad. Well, actually, he nailed the Scar Award. Just unfortunately didn't get it in the brush, which is sort of what happens when that happens. Barker now able to Tides of Blood this wave yet again. Hold that one off just so that he can pick up every single bit, but PYL throwing some barrels around as Imp, Blood Boiled up, going to be trying to take down this dragon. Beast is here. He did spot things out there with a pillar as God V has come through, and Consume is going to lock away the dragon. So dragon's all tied up.
And TBQ, he's gone Sightstone. We see this a lot on Nunu's getting that before the Cinderhulk. The reason I even like it further on this team composition is because what they want to do is they want to get the jungle warded up, make sure that they can spot out when the jungler goes to grab different buffs or even leaves that side of the jungle and be able to rotate quickly into other lanes. So you see Imp as well as PYL. They're 2v2ing right now against a Hurricane. Good adaptation coming through from Crystal. He's not looking to win any skirmishes, looking to just match the push that will come through from Imp and
yep.
clear out turrets very, very quickly. So might not be able to get much done. Baka, he pushes back very well. Not to mention the fact that a Hurricaned up Callista is going to be doing a good job. So they might be able to normalize this map. On the other side, though, Imp just wants to push and take structures at the moment. That's what Jinx does best at this point in the game before picking up much and is going to look to pressure, although Crystal clears out once again.
Yep, no worries at all. Before it even gets to the turret here, make sure that he picks up every single one of these creeps. He's still in touching distance of that CS that Imp has managed to create himself a little bit of a lead in. Cute little wall to come through as Bark is going to get crit, but Transfusion is going to help him stay healthy here. As you can see, Will of the Ancients, pretty handy with that 20% spell vamp, helping him stay alive, despite the fact that he already had a little bit in his kit there.
The teleport! So smart coming through there because they keep a creep alive the entirety of the time. Fast push is on for LGD, and that's a really cute move for Akon.
That was fantastic. And Flandre, of course, cancelled his out. He was actually just transforming into that Meganar, but Snake have decided that they want to trade for this mid-outer.
Yeah, they're not going to be able to get it. Godvi's there. He clears out waves very well himself. In fact, gets a stun down onto Barker.
Well, that is really starting to do some hurt now.
Yeah, it certainly is, and everyone's behind.
Yeah, in fact, Barrel is going to be dodged there by Barker. Uses that pull in order to stop that one from displacing him. And LGD, they move their Jinx into the mid lane.
Yeah, so now they're looking to take the last outer at only 12 minutes in. LGD stacking up a huge early lead. And that is just fantastic play coming through from the entire team.
Yeah, and there's the Fates call to come through. Crystal looking to start something up here, actually, but of course only has that Hurricane. Beast coming through from the backside. We've got Flandre here as well. Doesn't quite have that much rage, but the LGD members are quite low. Akon taking a lot of damage as Crystal's getting some rends onto people. Imp gets caught by the box, but he's doing a lot of damage with the rockets, and Beast trying to change his position. Imp completely away from everyone as Godvi gets egged here in the mid lane. Flandre tanking at the turret though, but Crystal, he's found Imp, but as Imp found Crystal, oh my goodness, he survives as Beast coming through with the Frozen Domain. Imp trying to kite him around, but just gets bitten. But he traded one for one there. It is going to be LGD falling a couple of members, but Snake, man, they lose all of their outer turrets.
Yeah, so they lose all three outer turrets, get an advantageous team fight, but look at the power builds coming through. Imp already on his Infinity Edge, able to pick that one up. There's a Righteous Glory about to be finished for Maokai as well. Not to mention Sightstone and Cinderhulk finished up for Nunu. He can go back and shop as well. Pretty sure he's got another 800 gold in his pocket.
Not too bad.
So all in all, really nice map movements coming through early mean a 2,000 gold advantage for LGD.
Yeah, and despite Beast having a 101 scoreline in comparison to TBQ's 000, he is still behind about 1,000 gold. Of course, TBQ's just been able to eat the jungle.
Yeah, exactly right. He's been flying through on Nunu, takes the big camps especially really quickly. So we'll see how this goes throughout the entirety of the game. PYL on Gragas has not really looked that impressive. I'm not sure what support Gragas does. I think that he used his barrel ineffectively.
He baits out pulls. He baits out pulls is what he does.
He really used that barrel ineffectively. He got the pull, but he could have used it to push people away from the turret and maybe even avoided that teamfight. As Imp, he's been caught.
Yeah, Frozen Domain going to come through here as the Chompers come down, but it's only going to stop Beast. Subjugate actually onto Imp as he's trying to turn around. Super Mega Death Rocket. Flandre, no, the last auto attack from that caster creep, not going to kill him. Oh my goodness, the dodge away as PYL's getting kited through here. PYL does pick up the kill somehow with
he
a stray
just
barrel.
He ignited him.
Oh my goodness.
He walked
goodness.
In there, ignited him, and then just peaced out. PYL with a swag walk away.
In the end, it was a one for one, but yeah, that was pretty cute.
Yeah, he uses the flash, uses the barrel, in the end just ignited.
A little bit sad. Little bit sad. Of course, PYL probably hasn't had too much practice on the old support Gragas. I don't know whether that was a strategy normally used.
Do not say that. PYL.
He's probably played it, let's be honest.
He plays Gragas, I guarantee it.
He's probably played anything. I wonder how his Malzahar support looks.
Brand oh, they support out Beast. PYL going in.
Yeah, they're looking for something here. The Trundle, the Pillar, not going to be quite enough as the Warning Cone coming through. Definitely working out here, but Beast is able to turn this one as Flandre's coming in. PYL, not the tanky Gragas you're looking for, but man, why did Beast walk back in there?
Yeah, that was a little bit of a strange pathing coming through there as now Bucket, he's on top of a ward with Crystal. They're looking to get inside positioning on this middle lane, try and siege that one up, but that is a very hard task into an interview.
Yeah, especially when they're only 4 versus 5 here. Akon doesn't have his teleport though, so not going to be able to get there. So 4v4 at that stage. POL at half health is going to be heading back. Barker still with an advantage as far as that CS is concerned and does have an assist as well as Godby, so probably going to be ahead on that goal just a little bit. Of course, Turret's going to be helping out there as far as Godby's concerned, so he's probably actually doing quite okay, going for a massively mana-hungry build.
Yeah, actually picks up the tier. Normally when you see Roller first item, you don't see the tier come through. It's only on about 110 stacks there for Godby. We'll probably pick up a Chalice after that as well, so you would expect 3 items centered around that mana.
Pretty strange. Dragon is at half health here, and of course they're secure. Very, very strong as Consume does come through. Beautiful double stun there from the Flash Frost as TBQ's taking a lot of damage. Acorn right in amongst the Super Mega Death Rocket comes around the top, but Flandre trying to zone them out. Hemoplague doing so much work onto these members. There it explodes, and LGD have no life left at all. The Ren comes through. Crystal picks up a kill. He's looking to try and get something back as Imp in the back line with the range advantage doing some work. Barker trying to come through. Godby looking for the crit. Acorn goes down as the pull comes in and Barker flashing away, but Imp using that vision quite nicely, and Beast is going to get slowed down, stunned up and destroyed by Godby.
Yeah, so in the end, they're able to win the team fight. They get the dragon as well. I was going to say they're going to look for Baron, but no, they're not. They're just going to walk into the jungle because it's only 17 minutes into the game.
Yeah, they might look for Baron. They don't quite know where it is at the moment.
Oh, he sleeps until 20 minutes.
Yeah, but
he's a bit of a late riser.
He comes out of somewhere, okay? So they might just go for some tunneling play. Don't actually have Rek'Sai. He was banned away. She was banned
away.
Yep. My goodness. It's very, very confusing there when you've got desert beasts that are ladies. I'm sorry, Rek'Sai.
She's not a desert beast. She's a void beast.
Yeah, I remember the video where it was in the desert.
I do. That was a good video as well. As Acorn actually goes very deep onto Kalista.
Yeah, looking for the Twisted Advance. Finds it here as well as Crystal takes the Dark Pass. Super Mega Death Rocket blocked by Ella as Acorn's going to find it with that Arcane Smash. Ella flashes out of the way as PYL gets death sentenced closer to Ella and allows him to continue to get slowed down. Acorn picks up the kill, and LGD, they're looking very good after these last couple of fights.
Yeah, they certainly are, and in the end, Trundle just not doing too much. as it comes through 2-2 and 3. So not having a horrible scoreline, but not able to save very many people in that jungle. In the end, just had to roam away. And this fast push composition is actually really cute coming through from LGD. I like the way they've put it together. And Nivea and surprisingly Gragas are the linchpins of the composition, able to force people away from the turrets.
Yeah, and of course, I'm glad that we've mentioned Anivia here as well. That wall is just fantastic for zoning.
Yeah, and it forces people to move the way you want them. And when you've got the slows, like the zap that comes through, not to mention the fact that Maokai can get in on people as well. Godby, you're in trouble.
He is in trouble. Transfusion can come through. The tiny wall is actually going to save his life.
Oh, as a fantastic
pillar.
Pillar.
Yeah, the parking cone to come through. Akon going to teleport into the backside. Box comes through to stop TBQ from getting in here. But LGD, they're finding the fight that they want here as Hemoplay goes down onto TBQ, but not quite going to work out as Crystal does use the Fate's Call. The tiny wall again. Beautifully placed here by Godby as a pillar going to be used to disengage. And LGD, victorious fight yet again, although they only get Flandre.
Yeah, so they get Flandre, but now they have position over the top side of the map. There's a wave pushing in there, probably still not long enough on the death timers. Every single time they win a fight, I peek towards Baron. It's still not spawned.
You're still
just
spawned.
Just so
though.
Early in the game already, but 10-5, 5,000 gold the advantage already at only 20 minutes in. This is a huge game for LGD.
Yeah, and I understand why you're looking at the Baron, because things have gone from laning phase that ended at about 10 minutes now to the roaming style of the mid game. Before the mid-game should have even been here.
Yeah, exactly right. And it's really hurt Vladimir. It's hurt Jinx because they've been fighting before their two-item spikes. Not to mention Trundle, who would definitely be looking to farm. He wants to be able to get up there, and he's just not able to grab any CS for himself, which means he's pretty much a pillar and ult bot at this part of the game, which he doesn't want to be, especially because no one's really got any resistances to steal. Who are you ulting? Like, maybe Acorn?
Yeah. No, oh, Glacial Shroud on both Akon and TBQ, but Snake, they're looking for a fight here as Barker going in, but he's running away from his team. Flandre looking for Imp here, doesn't find the Gnar on him, but PYL caught out just a little bit. Barker still alive here, uses the pull. Super Mega Death Rocket under Flandre as Barker so low, not many options here, but takes down PYL. Flandre getting rocketed as Imp is just going off, gets excited. Beast not taking too much damage, but will eventually go down. Three dead, and now the Baron spawned. Spawn, and LGD going to take it down.
Yeah, so they're able to get in there. They're still very squishy. Need to be careful here. It's at 4,000 health, so they'll probably get it. But you can
Crystal.
Never be too sure.
Yeah, he's looking for something here, but Imp, so much damage, gets to him before he takes the lantern out, and Imp even secures the Baron.
Yeah, PYL unfortunately just didn't get it, so it's only on four members, but 21 minutes in, LGD have complete control over this game.
Yeah, and that sort of just erupted after one team fight, and we've seen this happen by LGD. They just look so good when they win a fight that they can take control of, and then they just take every objective, and then they just roll over the top of you.
Yeah, for me, it wasn't even a team fight this game. It was a teleport into the bot lane
that
where
Akon
started the fast push. It got them a 2,000 gold advantage, and you say, so what? But at 10 minutes into the game, to lose complete control of your map is absolutely massive, and it all came through a non-interaction. Akon just made sure that creep couldn't die and then took the rest of the map.
Yeah, and it's destroyed Beast's ability to get into this game entirely.
Yeah, exactly right. Beast is nowhere near this game. Once again, Flandre very far behind, and you would think that Gnar probably needs more gold than a Maokai to be effective. Maokai, very useful with his ultimate still. Flandre, you can say the same thing about him, but he just hasn't been able to get onto Imp, who's now finished up a Phantom Dancer against not even a Hurricane coming, a Bloodthirster coming through here for Crystal. Imp is so far ahead. Also has a Potion of Wrath. Love that pickup because with Super Mega Death Rocket Zap, you get so much life back from the auto attacks and all the AD abilities that come out of Jinx. And now they're rolling through. They've got a fast push comp with Baron at 22 minutes. There's no way that Snake can defend turrets anymore.
No, and they couldn't defend turrets anyway. Of course, you were talking about the Anivia, the Gragas here as well. That Explosive Cask almost going to be back off cooldown very soon. Of course, doesn't have a huge timer on that one. And Imp just going to eat through these minion waves. Snake looking to try and defend. Saplings coming around the back as Akon looking to zone them away. And look at how quickly that turret melts.
Yeah, able to eat through that one. The potion's hooked up. Godby gets hooked, but nothing coming through. And now they have to fight because otherwise their base will be breached.
Yeah, the smite was actually used there. Barker takes half of his health. The wall actually locks him in here. Has to take the dark passage as the ult comes through from TBQ. Siege minions are doing some work here. We'll see whether Snake can actually clear those ones out, but another minion wave is coming. LGD, they're happy to wait. The minion wave's not doing too badly for them in the other lanes either. As the barrel's coming through to zone. The wall going to be available again soon. Pierce not doing any damage. Righteous Glory onto Crystal. He's the one that's the focus as Akon actually drops the aggro on the turret. But you can see Imp just wants to take that one down as Hemoblade comes through. Barker tries to run away. He's got the ghost on him. But Kalissa takes down Akon. The turret not dead yet. PYL gets played back in. Death sentenced as well. And Barker picks up that kill. Snake still alive. They're very, very low. But LGD, they can't break the base just yet.
Yeah, they're waiting for one more creep wave. This is an overcommit, you feel, coming from LGD. Imp wants nothing to do with it. Wow!
Super Mega Death Rocket, so much damage. Imp locks down the kill under Kalissa as the Dark Passage comes through for Beast as well. And Barker at full health now. Godby gonna flash out of the way. Imp, no mana, but he can definitely do the damage. Flandre tries to pick up the last one, doesn't get it. Excited Imp, he gets ignited, but it doesn't even matter as that Potion of Wrath does so much work. And LGD, they're trying to win the game.
Yeah, they're going to win the game at 24 minutes in. This Jinx has gone absolutely nuts. Actually might not be able to get it. Creeps are running out and Baron expired.
They're going to have to watch out. Yeah, they're going to have to watch out for the aggro of the turrets. That is Lost Teams games, Spawn. That is most certainly Lost Teams games.
Don't know what you're talking about there, mate. Not touching that one already, unfortunately. Made a little bit of fun of Dame. As, yeah, zoom in on Imp. He's going back to base.
What a game coming out of the AD carry of LGD. Has gone absolutely berserk this game. 100%
kill participation on Jinx.
Yeah, and his three items at 25 minutes. 9-2-9 has been an absolute machine.
A complete machine gun, you have to say. That was terrible. TBQ, though, 2-0-14. 16 out of 18 ain't bad either, and TBQ has just been so impressive. Ella, Super Mega Death Rocket steals the blue.
Gets it with a Super
that
Mega
Death
That is
some
Death
pretty
Rocket.
Quick double buffs coming through from Imp without killing anyone.
Yeah, it certainly is. So able to pick that one up as we actually take a replay.
This I thought we were going to see the blue steal.
Yeah, so did I. As we see, this is a double stun. So Godvi lines this up and nails. Actually, didn't get Flandre, but got Barker. And in the end, dangerous game. Such a good passive. Always pick that one up there, guys.
But look at that. Dangerous game again, gets him through the ignite.
Yeah, exactly right. Able to live. I actually wanted to see the fake out because he had me completely buffed. Backed away from the turret and then fired Super Mega Death Rocket into Crystal.
Yeah.
And just auto-attacked him once for the kill. Was a really nice mind game coming through from the AD carry of LGD. And now Flandre, he's trying to deal with super creeps at 26 minutes in and not very farm. They're trying to push in on the bottom turret, top turret now.
And Crystal not even with his last whisper completed just yet. Crystal not going to be able to do too much as far as defense is concerned. Kalista not with too much range. And Beast does nothing at all. Inner turret is going to fall down. Barker managed to push out the mid wave. Crystal going to clear out this ward. But man, this turret is not long for this world. Beast gets stunned up. There's the crit to come through as well as he uses the subjugate. Yeah, we'll get some health back from that. But you can see the turret not going to. It's going to get taken down very, very low. Beast. He's going to eat a Flame Chomper just for the fun of it. And Flandre does have that Mega Gnar form. So LGD going to back away for now. But
they've used nothing. They can continue to zone here with all of their ultimates available. They can even just use PYLs to shove them off this turret here and then take it down.
Yeah, Flandre actually back into Mini Gnar form here as well. Barker has to take a Dark Passage. Crystal in the front line as TBQ gets Death Sentence. It's not the target they want to lock in as Imp. Looking for Barker, just complete zone control by this AD carry. And Imp's Jinx has just looked so good.
Yeah, it certainly has. They'll be able to take another inhibitor as PYL pauses, body slams over a wall, Baron up in 30 seconds. And you feel that's probably the next objective coming through from LGD.
Yeah, and Godvi just letting everyone know exactly how League of Legends used to be before the base gates by putting up a wall in front of it. A little bit cute there. Spirit Visage was finished by Beast, so he's able to get a little bit more health back from his passive and, of course, the subjugate. But that's all you can really say about this Trundle, who doesn't do any damage and isn't all that tanky.
Yeah, he's just been, yeah, had the...
Non-factor.
Yeah, had the game dictated to him, I think. And unfortunately, you can probably say it about a couple of people. Flandre's second horrible game in a row coming through from the top laner out of Snake as well. Acorn, much more effective again as well. They go in for a fight.
Yeah, P-Whale on his own and amongst three members doesn't lose any health or weight. He's going to get walloped there as Flandre is going to lose out on... Oh my goodness, actually caught out here. Beautiful flash frost. He's going to get flashed out of the way of. And the Baron is going to get begun again here by LGD.
Yeah, so they're able to clear this one out. There is absolutely nothing Snake can do to stop that. 10,000 gold, make it 11 at only 28 minutes into the game. They're going to be able to shove down mid lane now, you feel. Take the last out of turret. Oh, they're going for a dragon. They've just got
boring.
Absolutely everything is in their control. Why not? If this game goes for another 6 minutes, they'll have a fifth dragon as well. Just finish it out clinically. This is very patient, good play coming through from LGD.
Yeah.
They've seen a couple of the throws.
Yeah, we did mention pitches. Not dying to Nexus turrets
before. Yeah, the pitches coming through here. Mm-hmm. So we'll actually have to see whether they could just play this one slow, finish it off.
Yeah, well, Snake looking to try and find their way back into this game. Going to be very, very difficult. Of course, Barker still with a CS advantage. And Crystal has picked up that last whisper. There's the possibility of some sort of advantageous exchange that can be spread into something. But of course, LGD have got an incredible late game team comp for a team fight as well. I mean, it's not like they're going to get outscaled ever. They've got this gigantic lead. It doesn't matter about scaling, does it really, when it's 9 turrets to 1, 18 kills to 8, and an 11,000 gold lead with 4 dragons to 1?
One thing you will say is that they wave clear very well. They aren't going to be able to, if they get a pick and then like are able to delay this game a little bit, something like that, and they continue to wave clear, they're going to pick up a lot of gold around the map.
It's true.
They're very optimistic coming through here, but that's probably the best you can say right now is they're going for that pick.
Yeah, hook onto PYL. They're trying to pick him up, of course. Oh, the pillar not really helping Snake continue that one as it pushes PYL a little bit further away. They do clear out the ward, and now LGD looking to pick up the open inhibitor. Barker takes not a crit. Imp would have probably taken off half of his health if that one had to come through. He does have the red buff here, probably from Snake's base. He's going to clear out this vision over the side. LGD are definitely playing this one super safe.
Yeah, they're just playing it smart. There's no reason to rush. It's only 30 minutes in. They're going to be able to pick up the minion wave now, follow that one into the base, and because they've taken out top and bottom, they'll just be able to push through.
Yep, Baroned up minions as well. Of course, they did pick that one up. That one's going to die so fast as TBQ looking to start this fight off. Ella has to flash away as Godby picks up the kill so easily. The Gnar into the wall and the PYL, but he just body slams his way out. Hemoplague not going to do too much work either. Locket of the Iron Solari used by LGD. And man, Godby is just tearing apart the members of Snake. Flandre as well. Crystal, oh my goodness, Imp with a gigantic crit. Not even sure whether it is as... That one was not needed, but man, this Jinx doing some damage. And LGD, they wipe the floor with Snake.
Yeah, another clinical game coming through from LGD. They're going to pick up a 2-0 win. They're actually going for another kill. Bucker won't give it over to them. That's a little bit mean. But the Nexus explodes.
Yeah, and of course, yeah, Bucker does allow them to parade around the fountain
happy.
There. Imp is looking very happy. Takes his jumper off. And he's saying, yep, it's time to get serious. And man, did he get serious that game.
Yeah, 11 to 11. He was an absolute... He was godlike in the end.
Yeah, and they already have Godby.
Yeah, exactly right. So they're able to pull out another win, and they did it this time with a real strange team comp.
They did, and of course it was answered by a real strange team comp, but LGDs just seemed to work out a whole lot better. PYL on the support, Gragas, although in the early game did miss a couple of ultimates here. He tried to go for a red steal, didn't quite get that, but he was baiting out Snake the whole time, and they could not kill him.
I'm sorry, I'm not on the PYL Gragas hype train at all. The comp could have worked with or without him. He did absolutely nothing. But
look,
in the
they won the game,
it was
didn't
all
they?
About the Anivia, the Nunu, and the Jinx, and they looked fantastic.
They most certainly did. Imp actually managed to keep that 100% kill participation with the 11-2-11, and man, I just don't know what you're going to do in response to that game, because what, do you ban out the first game and the second game? It's going to be ridiculous. But ladies and gentlemen, this is a best of five, and Snake going to see whether they can come back in the